I was skeptical about using AI at first, but then I kept hearing about ChatGPT. So I finally tried it. Well, it's better than expected, and it actually kind of shocked me. Now, you can use ChatGPT for all sorts of things, from productivity to writing to idea generation, but today we're going to focus on blogging and if you own a niche authority website. But these tips can help you if you do anything online, including writing on a blog, maybe you're a freelancer, maybe you do podcasts, maybe you create videos for YouTube, or just generally produce on social media. These tips should be able to help you out. Now, let's go over to ChatGPT, and for the interest of time, I already typed this stuff ahead of time so you don't have to watch me type, and we don't have to wait for the responses. So we're going to jump in, and I'm going to show you 7 ways you can use ChatGPT today to help you be more efficient writing for your blog or producing content online. I've been focusing on bullet journaling for a couple weeks here, and I thought that's a good topic to get into. So the first thing you can use ChatGPT for is coming up with a domain name. So I wrote in here, what are 10 catchy domain names for a site dedicated to bullet journaling? And we got 10 here. So bulletjournal.hq, the Bullet Journal Zone, Bullet Journal Mania, Bullet Journal Genius, and so on. There's 10 listed. It does say, keep in mind that these domain names may already be taken, so you may need to get creative or adding additional keywords to make it unique. Number 2 is finding keywords. So I'm a big fan of long tail keywords, including the keyword golden ratio, which is another topic. I'll link to it if you want to learn more about the keyword golden ratio. But I said this, provide 20 long tail keywords related to bullet journaling so that I could write blog post about them to get Google search traffic. So here are 20 long tail keywords: bullet journaling for beginners, for productivity, for students, journaling spreads for monthly planning, and so on. I'm not going to read them all out here, but I'll put them in the description so that you can check them out along with other links that you might find helpful. So these are all unique. And I thought, well, that's great. 20 of them, 20 keywords. How about this, ChatGPT? Can you provide 10 more? So ChatGPT provided me with 10 more. That's fantastic. And a little subtopic here, so this one counts too, but you could also ask for formatting. So I said, hey, ChatGPT, can you put all 30 keywords in a bulleted list? So ChatGPT can remember what you used in the previous chat. So here's all of the 30 long tail keywords, and I just put it in a bulleted list, but you could say, hey, put it in a numbered list or whatever. 4 is clusters. So you can group the topical things together, but here's 30 things. I didn't think about it ahead of time. So I said, ChatGPT, can you put the 30 keywords in related topic clusters for content silos? Sure, no problem. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 clusters, each with 6 in there, evenly spaced. I mean, it's fantastic. It's already outlined for us. So bullet journaling for productivity and goal tracking, it already put them in the clusters. For self-care and wellness, you may need to, you know, double check, and maybe you are going to cover a topic in a certain way and you want to move it around or something like that. Next one, number 5, FAQs. What are 20 frequently asked questions related to bullet journaling? And we have 20 of them here. They're all numbered out. Some of them may be a little bit redundant from the previous, but that's okay. So we have bullet journaling for personal development and reflection. How do I set up my bullet journal? Maybe we could say, you know, nothing about pets, for example. So you can do more and more of this. So that's number 5. Let's say you pick one and you want to write about that specific topic. So write a detailed outline for a blog post about one of the keywords that we found before. So bullet journaling for productivity. Of course, ChatGPT is so friendly. It says, sure, here's the detailed outline. So we have introduction. We have a definition of bullet journaling. We have setting up. I'm not going to read the whole thing out, but you could use this next section. So like use your bullet journal for task management on a daily basis, and then tracking your progress and achievements, staying motivated, and then the conclusion. Let's say you're working with a writer. You could take that outline, give it to the writer, and then they have a good starting point. Maybe you're writing it yourself, so you could take it and go from there. But let's say you're really lazy. Don't be lazy, but let's say you're really lazy. You can say, write the blog introduction. So this is number 7, including the introduction. And I put the couple bullet points because I want to make sure they include it. So definition of bullet journaling and a brief overview of the benefits of bullet journaling for productivity. So here is the introduction. So it wrote this couple paragraphs as the introduction. And you can do this for the rest of the paragraphs. If you have any questions, ask in the comments below. Be sure to check out the other videos. I'm going to be doing more on ChatGPT, and there's a link for free resources related to ChatGPT, OpenAI, and other AI tools out there. Thanks a lot. Be sure to check out other videos, especially about niche websites, if you're interested in making money online.